In the summer of 2021, a small dog food brand recalled foods because they contained a deadly cancer-causing mold. Now, nobody paid that much attention to it because they were small brands, but I want to show you how virtually every kibble on the shelf today contains this same deadly mold and why this should really scare you. Before we get started, make sure you subscribe to this channel, and if you're on YouTube, click the alert notification. So if you don't know what mycotoxin is, it's a toxic byproduct produced by mold. One of the most well-known and the most toxic mycotoxins is Aflatoxin B1. Now, aflatoxin is kind of a big deal because it's the number one most carcinogenic naturally occurring substance in the world. But all mycotoxins are really toxic to the liver, as well as the kidneys, brain, and heart. So where do these mycotoxins come from? Well, they usually contaminate grain crops, especially corn, barley, and wheat, but they can also be found in beets and peanuts. Those are the most common sources, but aflatoxin can also frequently be found in rice, millet, sorghum, and seed oils, just about anything that's vegetable. So just how prevalent is aflatoxin contamination? Well, a 2015 study looked for 5 different mycotoxins in 48 kibbles. Half the foods were premium foods, and all but one of the premium foods had at least 2 types of mycotoxins in them, while more than half the samples had at least 3 different mycotoxins. In fact, one premium brand had all 5 mycotoxins they were testing for. And there have been multiple studies showing that mycotoxins are running wild in dog food. In fact, the Consumer Council of Hong Kong found that the worst mycotoxin, aflatoxin, was found in Purina Hills and Aviderm. And Purina responded by saying that mycotoxins are unavoidable natural contaminant. So mycotoxins are really common, and pet food makers say that they're unavoidable. Well, actually they could be avoided if they test for mycotoxins before the food leaves their plant. And if you feed your dog kibble, it's a good idea to call up your manufacturer and ask them for that test. In fact, do me a favor, and if you contact them, let me know what they say in the comments below. So mycotoxins are in most kibbles to some extent. Remember, they're an unavoidable contaminant. Pet food makers knew this was a big deal way back in 2007. They knew then that mycotoxins cause chronic diseases like kidney and liver disease, immunosuppression, and cancer. And they were concerned about this for 2 reasons. First, the FDA has set limits on the amount of mycotoxins that can be in pet foods, but don't feel all warm and fuzzy about that because mycotoxins build up in the body and there's a cumulative effect. And this isn't accounted for. Nobody really knows a safe limit, but researchers all agree it's important to limit mycotoxin exposure as much as possible. And 2, when more than one mycotoxin is in a food, they can interact and become more toxic. So the safe limit only applies if there's only one mycotoxin present. So to summarize, mycotoxins are bad. They build up in the body and cause all of these diseases that we mistakenly think are due to old age. And they're very likely to be in any dog food that's half vegetable matter, like kibble. So how do you avoid mycotoxins in pet foods? Well, first, just don't feed grains, seed oils, and legumes. Feed your dog a raw or dried diet that's not half starch. Even a canned diet would be better. But if that's not in your budget, then at the very least, avoid kibbles with corn, barley, and wheat. These are the crops that are most likely to be harboring mycotoxins. And finally, don't feed any kibble without first asking the manufacturer for independent testing showing that the food is low in aflatoxin and mycotoxins. If they don't have one, then buy another food. Either way, let us know in the comments below and you'll be helping out other dog owners who are worried about one of the biggest threats to dogs eating kibble. And if you like this video, please like it, share it, and tell people about it. Thanks for watching.